In this video, we are going to talk about campaign management in detail. So let's start with what is campaign management. Marketing campaigns are the perfect way to reach out to your customers, clients, and leads. Also, adding an incentive lets you follow up with the customers. It lets you explain your services and promote your brands even further. And this makes marketing campaigns an important piece of any B2B sales strategy. Now, for the same reasons, campaigns can be managed in CRM itself for the organizations. They can have their campaigns within Salesforce, wherein they can keep a track of how many leads have been converted so far, what is the revenue that has been generated so far from a particular campaign. And similarly, you can have multiple campaign within one parent campaign as well. So let's say we have some fair trade show is going on, and we wanted to that is one campaign, and we want to have multiple other sub modules of it. So in a trade fair, you will have electronics, you will have automobile. So you will have different separate campaigns for electronics and automobile. But both of those campaigns would fall under one parent campaign, that would be a fair trade show. So let's just quickly go to the campaigns and create a new campaign so that we can have the better clarity of things. Let's name the campaign. So this is the only one mandatory field that is there in the new campaign page. So I'll name it as Summer Fair 2021. We can make the campaign active and inactive by simply clicking on this checkbox. The type of my campaign is a trade show. Status of my campaign is plan. I'm pre-planning the campaign. The campaign would start from 15th of April and it will end on 20th of April. It's a 5-day campaign. The revenue that is expected in this campaign is expected to flow in this campaign is, for say, is 1 million. So we are expecting a revenue of 1 million. Budgeted cost, so company has allocated for say $5,000 for this campaign. Actual cost is something which we do not know until this point. Similarly, we can have expected response as well. So I am expecting a 20% response out of this campaign. And then you can fill in the description and just simply click on the save. By clicking on the save option, you have successfully created a campaign by the name Summer Fair 2021. In the related list, you can see the campaign hierarchy. So campaign hierarchy is nothing but will tell you about the other campaigns that has been associated with this particular parent campaign, that is Summer Fair 2021. So until this point, nothing is basically associated with this campaign. Attachments, if there would be any attachments related to this campaign that can be stored or uploaded here. Opportunities will show that how many opportunities has been added to this particular campaign and how many of them has won, how and what is the current status of any opportunity that is there in this campaign. In campaign members related list, you can see all the members. A member could be a lead or a contact. So we can add multiple members, n number of members to this campaign. To whom we want to reach out through this campaign. Now coming on details page, detail of campaign, basically if you look at the left side of the detail page, you'll see all the values that we have filled in at the time of creating the campaign. So my campaign is Summer Fair, it is an active campaign, type of trade show, and all those details which we have filled in earlier. On the right hand side, you'll see some of these parameters which will give you a holistic view of the campaign, that how your campaign is going at a certain point in time. So it will tell you about the number of leads that are there in the campaign, out of those leads how many are the converted leads, how many contacts are there, how many of them has responded, this we are talking about campaign members. How many opportunities are there in this campaign? How many we have won so far? Value opportunities campaign. So this would be the cumulative sum of amount of the opportunities that are there in this campaign. And value one would be the converted opportunities cumulative count amount. So in this, we can have the holistic view of your campaign at how much progress you have made so far and things around that. Now I'll go back to the related list and we'll talk a little more about the campaign hierarchy, how we can associate multiple campaigns with a parent campaign. So as we have talked about at the starting of this video, that there could be one scenario where we want to run a campaign under the name of Summer Fair 2021. So this would be our umbrella campaign, and under this campaign there could be different campaigns, some modules of this campaign, automobile, electronics, for whom we want to run separate campaigns, and we want to track the progress of each campaign separately. So I have already created this automobile campaign, no details. I've just simply created this campaign just to give you a understanding of how campaign hierarchy looks like. So let's go to the details page and let's see if there's any parent campaign that has been associated with this. So nothing has been associated so far. We click on the edit button and we'll associate this campaign automobile with Summer Fair 2021, and we'll click on the save button. Now when I go back, similarly let's associate one more campaign. So I've created this campaign by the name of electronics. I'll just go to the details and associate this particular campaign with the parent campaign, that is our Summer Fair 2021. So I'll save this. Now when you go back to the parent campaign, that was our umbrella campaign Summer Fair 2021, in the related list, in the campaign hierarchy, you can see both the two sub campaigns. So yeah, so this is where you can see all the campaigns that have been associated with this parent campaign. So automobile and electronics are two different campaigns, so you can manage these two different campaigns separately, and this will give you the holistic view of everything that is going around between these two campaigns, sub campaigns. Now this is about the campaign hierarchy. So depending upon your use case or your requirement business ask, you can just create the different, you can create multiple, you can associate multiple campaigns within one campaign and likewise. Now we will talk about the opportunity. So before talking about the opportunity, let's talk about the campaign members. Since as in when we are going to add the campaign members, so associated opportunities with the contacts or leads that we are going to add as campaign members will reflect in the opportunities automatically. So let's add few leads to this. Let's add some campaign members. So for this, I'll add David Monaco, Christine Akin, and Bertha Boxer. Yeah, so I've selected these three leads and I'll just click on the next button to add these three leads as campaign members. Now the member status is something which will send that what is the status, whether we have sent the proposal to the campaign members or if they have responded back. So currently let's say we have sent the proposal, we have sent the campaign details to these three leads. So let's select the member status as sent. Later on, as in when this is going to change, we can just definitely go back and update the status to responded. So I've successfully added three leads to this campaign. Let's add a couple of contacts as well. So let's add Jack Rogers and Betty Bear as two of the contacts. So I also want to add these two contacts as my campaign members. Similar thing, I'll keep the status as sent, member status sent, and we'll click on the submit button. Now that you can see that we have total number of five members, campaign members. Clicking on the view all option, I can have the list of the contacts and leads that are there as a part of campaign members. So there you can see the different contacts. Now we have talked about the status. So let's say few of my contacts, so let's say Betty and Kristen are two of the personals from lead and contact that have responded to our campaign mail, or if that has sent through mail, and I want to update the status to responded. So I'll select both of them. I go to the update status and we'll update the status responded. So now I can see that Christine and Betty's status is responded. Similarly, you can make the changes as and when you feel like. Now go back to the Summer Fair campaign, our parent campaign, and let's look at the opportunity. So now I'm going to add a few opportunities to it as well. So let's say I will add, I will create an opportunity. Even we can just go and associate the opportunities that are there as a part of it. So let's go back to view all. So I can see American Banking Corp, Betty Bear is there. So American Betty Bank is going to something which will be a camp, which will be one opportunity for us to track. Or we can just simply create an opportunity. For this opportunity, we have amount of $50,000. My opportunity name is National Insurance. National Insurance. And now I've got this opportunity when I was just campaigning around with the members which I have in this campaign. I'll select this stage as prospecting, still in the prospecting stage. Close date would be 20th at the end of the campaign. Yeah, that is it. I'll just quickly save the record. So yeah, I can see one of the opportunities, National Insurance. Similarly, let's add one more opportunity to it. Let's say this one is for 1 lakh. For one lakh, yeah. Close date is again 20th. Opportunity name is American Banking. American Banking. And I'll make it so it's in the qualification stage, let's say. Now I have two opportunities with different account. One is 50,000, one is for 1 lakh. I have in total 5 campaign members. We can also send a list emails to them. We can import leads and contact directly and make them the campaign members. So and so forth. Yeah, we can have extensive list of members here in the campaign member list. So now go to the details section of the Summer Fair. Now that is something which we wanted to look at. So we have talked about the holistic view, dashboard kind of view. So here you can see that there were total three leads that are there in the campaign. 0 has been converted so far. 2 of the contacts are there. Responses, we have received 2 responses since we have updated status of those 2 campaign members. Opportunities, there are 2 opportunities as we have created 2 new opportunities out of this. 1 opportunity is 0. Value opportunities is the total sum, total amount which are there in both the opportunities. We have a 0 opportunity 1, so the value and opportunity in campaign is 0. Now let's just play around the responses. Let's see, we have converted one of those leads. So I'll go to the related list and see if we can just convert the lead. So let's say I have converted this lead. So I'll just open up this lead. This is my lead and I'll just make it converted. So I'll just convert it. So when I go back to my campaign, I should see one converted lead. Details, I'll see one converted lead. Similarly, let's say for since we had 3 opportunities, so we have 3 opportunities now. Let's see all the 3 opportunities. Now the lead that we have just converted is an opportunity now, which is at the prospecting stage. Now let's say for National Insurance, I'll just open this opportunity. I'll just close this opportunity, select close status 1, close 1. So we have converted this opportunity. Now the stage has been changed successfully. Now when I go back to my parent campaign, go back details, I can see that yeah, the world value which we have won through this campaign is 50,000. This is the total number. 3 is the opportunity. 1 is 1 opportunity. And so forth. So yeah, like so in this view, we can have a dashboard kind of view of a campaign. And the related list, we can see the campaign hierarchy, opportunities, and all the campaign members. So yes, that was around the campaign. I hope this video was helpful. Oh,